So I will present a new project that I started, which is called Andaki Store. My motivation for this project was to be able to store some sensitive, secure information, like database connections, passwords, sensitive parameters of an ADA web server. And this was my main concern, to be able to make sure that the configuration files that I'm using for my server are safe and secure, and which means that passwords are not clearly visible. And then when I started this project, I discovered that I needed a tool to also go further and be able to store my own password and accounts, and store even complete documents, in order to, for example, we use a lot the cloud system, Amazon, Google, but they are not safe. And what I wanted is to be able to store securely some documents in these cloud system, and only store the encrypted document, but not store the encryption keys. So I have implemented some system which allows me to separate the data which is encrypted from the key which are used to encrypt the data. And all this is built in Ada with a library. So the library can be used. So here you have a simple example of the library. It's very simple. You just have an open operation where you give the name of the file that you want to open, and you give a password. And here, this is a simple example where you create a password. The password here is clearly available within the code. So it's not really safe, but this is for the purpose of the example. So with this small subset of ADA code, you open the key store, which is secure, and then you're able to get the value that is stored in the key store. So this is, the key store is just a name value key store, so that you can store everything. So in Ada, we can very easily, with this scheme, access some secure password from ADA code. Another example is more secure. We can protect the key store by using GPG, which means that the key store is protected by the private key, the user private key. So in that case, the initialization is almost similar. It's a little bit complex because for GPG, we need to provide some more context. But at the end, once you open the key store with the user secret key, you have the same API and you are able to retrieve the sensitive information which is stored in the key store. So on top of the key store, I have the ADA key store, which is a library. I've written the tool, which is AKT. So what the tool does is it takes the documents and stores them in the key store file. And each document, in fact, is protected by its own key. And all the keys are then stored in a key store, which is also protected by another key, which is locked by either the user password or a GPG protected key. I have been inspired by Lux, the encryption system available in Linux. So just to show an example, let's say I have two documents. The two documents are split in data fragments. Each fragment is around 4 kilobytes. And each data fragment is encrypted with its own key. So here, the first document, I have three different encryption keys. And for the second document, I have two data fragments, so two encryption keys. These encryption keys are associated with a name that I have given to my document. and they are protected by a directory key. And then the directory key is protected by a master key block, which is itself protected by the user password or by the user GPG protection key. The master key block, in fact, can be unlocked by there are seven slots, which allows you to unlock the master key block, which means that similar to Lux, you can define several passwords to be able to unlock the key store. What we can do with GPG is be able to share the same key store with several persons. So you create the key store and you initialize it by the GPG public key of each participant. So each participant will have its own GPG protection key, and each participant will be able to unlock the key store by using his own GPG private key. And we can go up to seven people. So at a key store, files are organized in blocks. So we have several blocks, some header blocks, with each block has some header, which is well known, and a footer at the end, which is a HMAC signature, which allows to make sure that the data is not corrupted and it is signed by the tool itself and by the signature that you have provided. All the keys are stored in two blocks, the master key block and the directory key block. So the master key block contains the primary keys to lock the key store, so you have up to seven slots, which allows you to unlock the key store. And then the directory block contains this is a small repository, in fact, which tells us what are the names stored in the key store and what are the index and where are the data associated with each of these names. And then the data is put in separate blocks and with fragments and some information about the fragment. And each fragment is encrypted by its own key, which is stored in this area. So what we can do is take the data block, put it on the cloud. You don't expose the secure key because the key used to encrypt the data are in fact are stored in the directory block, which you can separate. So this is the algorithm of the key protection. So it's using AES and HMAC 255 with a password-based key derivative. This is a GPG password encryption. This is a directory encryption. So this is each time new algorithm. Here you have the data encryption, then you have the directory decryption, then the directory data decryption. Well, a lot of them. But on top of these algorithms that I've quickly described, you have a lot of complexity, in fact. Complexity in managing the key store itself. When you insert the data, when you update data, when you want to have a secure ERAS of the data, I wanted to have a thread safe API and also be able to use multitask encryption and decryption for the whole system. So all these are new constraints on the implementation. So now I will describe a number of items that helped me to succeed in this project. So I've used limited types to describe how secure keys are represented. So it means that it helps by making sure that the secret key, in fact, once it is initialized, nobody else can copy my secret key, in fact. that's important. The second thing is the content of the secret key is in fact visible only to the encryption package, which will use it to encrypt and decrypt the content. So this is another property that ADA brings, which is important. And the last thing is the secret key type is using a limited control, which allows me to erase the content of the secret key as soon as the object is released. So it means that in terms of memory, when I create a secret key, I'm sure that it is erased when the object is no longer necessary. It may be strange because subtypes is very common. It's not new to ADA, but it has helped me significantly in the project. At the beginning, I was using stream element offset to compute indexes. So I have some block, and sometimes I have to initialize the block, for example. So you have access the block, the data at a given position. So of course, in ADA, you have an exception raised if the key position is out of bounds. But in my case, the key position is computed somewhere, maybe in another task. And when the exception is raised at the place where you use it, you don't know why the calculation that you have done is wrong. By using subtypes, I was able to make sure that the constraint of my key position applied at the position, at the place where I'm doing some computation. So in this case, it happened to me a lot of time to make an error in this kind of computation and therefore get an exception at this position where I do some computation and not at the place I'm using it. Another simple thing that helped me was the ADA private packages. It helped me to make sure, so in blue I have the public ADA packages. So KeyStore is the name of the primary package, so it has a files child package. I have a passwords child package, tools, GPG. So all these packages in blue describe the API of ADA KeyStore. And then in red, I have the private packages. So these private packages cannot be used outside of their container, but they can use inside. So this package cannot be used, is not public, so it cannot be used outside of the library. And even inside the library implementation, for example, I have this repository package, which is responsible for managing the content of the KeyStore, which with indexing names and values, retrieving values. So it has a repository which allows to insert, remove name entries, a part which allows to manage the keys, the encryption keys, and another part which manages to retrieve, to store and retrieve data. All these packages are private, so that I'm sure when I'm designing and I'm doing some refactoring or whatever, that the operations which are within these packages cannot be used outside of the program. So it helps to refactoring decision, because you know if you want to change something around these packages, reorganize some package, you know that the impact will be limited. I've used also preconditions, so it has helped me to define the nice for the API constraint. So for example, I have an operation which is contained, so I can define a precondition, so it can be used only if the container is open. You cannot verify that the name is contained in the container if it is locked, for example. And internally, I have also used use it to make sure that at various positions, at various steps when I'm doing some operation, the constraint here on the object is verified. Post condition, they are used also to clarify an API. For example, I have some internal API, some public API, which is get keys. And this API must fulfill this requirement, which is that the key length, the IV length, the sign length, which are out parameters, have to return a value which is exactly this length as parameter, as value. I've used also ADA protected types to make sure that the container and all inserting operation, removing operation is multitask safe. And in fact, doing this in ADA is very simple, in fact, because this object holds all the internal data structure that are necessary to manage the key store. And this is done very easily in ADA. Tasks are used for the encryption and decryption. So the library by itself does not create tasks, but it allows you to configure a number of tasks beforehand and indicate to the library a number of tasks that the library, the ADA KeyStore library, can use to decrypt and encrypt the content in parallel. So to be quick, this is the encryption, the decryption process. So you have a thread which wants to, for example, extract this document, which is composed of several data fragments. So we will start by to prepare some work queue, and for each work queue, we will indicate to the executor task the block number that it has to decrypt, some information about the key, where are the located the keys, and it will put the job in the executor queue. And then one of the tasks here will pick the job, and it will handle, in fact, all the decryption process, reading the block, decryption, verification of the HMAC signature, and at the end, it will put the result in a sequence queue, so that at the end, we have to pick the data in sequence, which means that the blocks here are processed independently of in whichever order, we don't care. But when we want to read them, we want to reconcile the order of our blocks, which means that we want to output the first number, the first block, second block, and so on, which is why there is this sequence queue. So it was hard. The project was difficult. Difficult because when you insert or update, the insert, update, and remove of data is difficult because you have to move data and within blocks and make sure that you make sure that offsets are correct and so on. And when you look at the data, because they are encrypted, it's random, so it's very difficult. The language, in fact, help a lot to make sure that, in fact, many errors were prevented in this, because the language. So despite this complexity, you have a simple ADA API that you can use. Thank you.
The AES algorithm. you wrote it yourself?
The question is, the AES algorithm was written by whom? Yes, I wrote the AES algorithm.
Have you for speed envisaged to use the Intel instructions?
No. It's completely portable. It runs on Intel and ARM. The question is about GPG and the limitation about the 7 slots. GPG may allow to have more, allow to compass this number of slots. Okay. The issue with the slot here is that we have to retrieve the master key, which is here, and this master key have to be encrypted by something. This something is different between user 1, user 2, and user 3, which is why it is encrypted by a different content, which is in fact retrieved by the GPG, which is retrieved by the GPG decryption made by using the user private key. You are right that I could share this between each user, but for me, this would bring some security hole because here I can remove, I can, for example, by using different slots, I have 3 users, for example. They are each of these 3 users have their own GPG slots. I can decide to withdraw the access of one user by erasing the slot that corresponds to that user. I would not have been able to do it if I was using the same, the same keys here to protect my wallet master keys. Yes. The question is it available in Alaya when you will accept my pool?
I get the idea of using the data fragments, but mostly for parallelization, I suppose. For encryption.
Yes, yes.
Question to me is slightly, why do you use a different key for each fragment? What's the decision behind
The question is, why do I use a different key for each fragment? The answer is security. If I have one key which is stolen, which is guessed or whatever, to be able to decrypt a large document, you will have to know all of the keys, not only one. So for me, it brings a better security by having each data fragment which has its own key. Also, another reason is if you update a document, I'm also generating a new key to, for the same reason, make sure that if a key one day or the other is found, updating create another key. So this is only for security. And the last reason is, in fact, I don't care about the space that these keys are using, in fact. I do care about the security, and my concern was to make sure that I put a lot of security aspects in this, and this is why I've used Ada to make sure that I don't have memory buffer overflow or things like this to reduce the scope of vulnerabilities, in fact.
How do you ensure that finalize actually finalizes? Because can happen.
The question is, how do I get sure that finalize really gets called and is not optimized? It's true that I'm not doing as correct as possible. In the implementation, I do not check, but I should do what was proposed in ADA Europe in 2016 or 17. There was a presentation at ADA Europe a long time ago that explained how to do it right. In the finalization, and basically you have to add some volatile constraint somewhere in the finalizer so that to prevent the compiler from removing the code that clears the key, the data. Well, but I'm not doing it.
Point of language, if it is a limited control type, the compiler is not allowed to remove the finalization. Well, you have to trust the compiler in any case. Okay? But according to the rules of the language, if it's a limited control type, finalization will not go.
Yeah, but the optimizer in the backend could decide that the thing is not used anymore. What's the point of writing data?
Then it's not conformant. And there is a bunch of tests in the validation suite about that.
How do you test that? Once the type is out of scope, it's out of scope. You can't test the value.
No, but the finalization is allowed to do anything, including calling failed or all the subprogram from the validation suite. The validation suite is designed to ensure that what has to be called is actually called.
I'm not worried about the call. I'm worried about the back end optimizing out the write operation.
But the C tests are executable.
Yes.
So typically, finalization could add some extra characters at the end of a buffer. And when the program terminates, it checks that the string has the resulting string has exactly one of the expected results.
Or you can just use the address.
Or you set Boolean or whatever in global variables. Plenty of ways to check that.
Yeah, but I remember the paper you were referring to.
Yeah.
It's not that easy.
Okay.
Would it be possible to also use a separate storage pool for this data?
Sorry.
Would it be possible to use a separate storage pool for the data and like?
The question is to use, is it possible to use a separate storage pool? Yes, this is a good question. In fact, the AKT tool, in fact, allows you to create a key store by splitting these files and having the data blocks stored in several files. I'm sorry, I have to go. So yes, you can do.